Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to take apart a steering wheel to get the steering wheel controls. Now the reason why you want to change out your steering controls, there might be a variety of reasons. For one, it's not working. These are buttons at the end of the day and they get used quite a bit. It's possible that you know, maybe it got wet or just from wear and tear. Maybe these buttons are worn out, so you want to replace them. So we're going to go over how to take apart the steering wheel and how to get these out so then you can just put new ones in. Before starting the job, because we're going to be dealing with electronics, we have to disconnect the battery. On this particular vehicle, we have a circuit breaker that we can just open up. To remove the horn, you can see that there are torques on the side. So every vehicle is going to be a little bit different. Some will use a push pin. In this case, it's a fastener. So we remove our ground wire here. Now every vehicle is going to be different. So this particular airbag plug, it has to pull back on it. So I'm going to use two hands. I'm going to get my buddy here to help Jason in. And then I'm going to pull back and remove it. Before we do anything, we have to index the nut and the steering wheel, preferably if we can. So, just gonna hit the nut with lubricant. Now, it is best if you let that sit for a while. We'll go ahead and impact it out. Now certain vehicles, it might be a little bit more dramatic trying to take off the steering wheel and you're gonna have to like really heave on it to get it off. If you are, be careful when you're pulling on it because it is soft metal in here. This steering wheel is designed to bend in an accident. So you wanna grab it around with two hands. This one actually, we're surprised, it came off really easy. So you can see here, we have one more connector here. This is probably for our steering wheel controls and everything for our clock spring. So I find sometimes grabbing a screwdriver and pushing down on the plug while holding the actual plug itself will allow me to get the plastic clips out all the way. With the steering wheel out of the vehicle, we can now start disassembling it. Off the ground. So for this particular steering wheel, those screws hold the back cover. Now we can turn it over and remove the rest of these screws that hold the cover for steering wheel controls. With the screws out, we're going to lightly go around and pry this out. If you guys are thinking about wrapping your steering wheel in some sort of vinyl or painting it or something, now is the time to do it. So now we have this all out. It'll probably be easier if I release the cruise control as well. Now, if you've already installed a new clock spring or you've already diagnosed it and it is the buttons, then go ahead and get new ones and then reinstall it. Okay, so now that you're ready for the new part, we just have to go ahead and do everything in reverse. Before we put the nut back on, we're gonna put a little bit of thread lock on there. And you can see that since we indexed it, this is how we're gonna put the steering wheel back on. So this steering wheel has a torque setting of about 34 foot-pounds. So we're going to tighten it up and we're going to make sure that our lines match up where we marked it off. Okay, we'll go ahead and plug our connector back into the clock spring and we can reinstall our horn. So I'm going to torque this up in increments. So right now I have it at 20. And then I'm going to do 30 and then 40. That's 40. So we have to have people hold the steering wheel because this vehicle is electronic the way it works. So when the battery's disconnected, I guess if the vehicle gets towed, it unlocks the steering wheel and we're never gonna get a good torque setting that way. So we have to have someone help me hold it as I torque it down. Plug our connector back into the clock spring and we can reinstall our horn. We're gonna go ahead and plug in our ground and our airbag as well. And tighten up our torques on the side. And now our steering wheel is nice and tight. So for those of you that are wondering, no, this is not a different vehicle, but we did take the opportunity to wrap this in carbon fiber wrap because the factory paint was just worn out so much, and it was just expensive to buy a brand new plastic piece. It made more sense to wrap it. Now the battery hooked up, everything's secure and double checked, we can go ahead and test the vehicle and turn it on. So we're going to test the horn, and we want to test our steering wheel controls. And now we have full functionality out of them again. And there you guys have it, that's how you change out the steering wheel controls.